Emma. Boardroom number three. Okay, sorry. Court is now in session for the trial of Mr. Miles Edgeworth. I'm an incompetent judge. Sometimes I have my moments. Yes. The defense is ready, Your Honor. Very well. Apparently, the prosecution is also ready. Who is this judge? Who is the judge here anyway? Mr. Von Karma, your opening statement? Very well. No opening statement, so...
Not so fast, Judge. I was taking a meaningful pause before speaking.
How long do you need to pause? Hang on. I was taking a meaningful sneeze for dramatic effect. Oh, God, allergies. Right, of course.
A prediction. With a snap, today's trial will end 3 minutes from now.
Does anybody want to time that? We'll see if he's right. Thank you, Avalon. Order! Order! Mr. Von Karma, what is the meaning of your statement just now?
Ah! Must you question everything? It will be over in 3 minutes. We have no time to waste. I'll call my witness now.
Right.
I call my witness, my decisive witness to the stand. I have the best witnesses, the greatest witnesses.
Sorry. It's that mysterious boat shop owner. It's Dad. Dad's coming to the stand.
Witness, state your profession.
I'm the proprietor of the restaurant, A Noodle at the Gold Lake.
And I also rent boats. Just for the kiddies, though.
The night of the incident, you were in the boat rental shop, correct?
Yep, I was.
Please testify.
Wait a second. We still haven't heard who this gold guy is.
Objection!
Wait a minute. The witness hasn't stated his name yet.
Because I did not ask him, Mr. Wright. Ah, I am predicting this trial will end in 3 minutes. I'm like Babe Ruth. I will point and the ball will go there. Stop asking trivial questions and cooperate.
I'm just gonna quickly.
Objection! Judge,
actually, you are leading the witness. You are right. You are very right. Judge, and it's his job to question things. I mean, yeah, right.
The witness will state his name.
Hey, easy. I'm old caretaker. Well, I'm not really sure. Yep.
What do you mean? My, memory is,
Your Honor! The witness does not remember anything beyond the last several years. Ergo, he cannot recall his own name.
You could have just said that, Karma.
He can't recall. Oh, sorry, wrong one. He can't recall, you say?
Yes, but the incident in question took place 3 days ago. He can testify.
Give me 1 second. I'm just gonna quickly just go blow my nose. Also, I feel like if you were legally going after this case, you could attack the witness under the guise that if they are unable to know their own name, that their memory is currently in question as to the events of 3 days ago. Am I wrong? Also, here's the other thing, is if you really want it to, like, put the nail in the hammer, or sorry, nail in the coffin, you could ask old hermit here who he thinks I am. If he says son, they'd be like, well...
No.
Wait, did you get an air purifier? I thought about that, but I don't know whether the moisture in the air would also be good for the two PCs and all the electronics I have around. So I'd have to look into that research-wise. The weird thing is, it's not a matter of, like, dry nose. It's just, like, the occasional, like, whiff of air that I get that just sends me for La La Land. I don't know why.
Very well. Let's hear your testimony then, shall we, witness?
Hey, to the murderer? Hey, it was in the 24th, just after midnight, yep. I was in the restaurant where I rent boats as usual. Then I heard a bang! Yep! When I looked out the window, I saw a boat just floating on the lake. Then I heard another bang!
Sorry. Added cheese, it makes me sad. Actually, yesterday... Ooh. So I haven't cooked toasted cheese in a very long time. And went ahead and I got some mozzarella cheese, a little bit of cheddar, a little bit of Monster on some sourdough, with a light drizzle of butter in between. And then I took some turkey bacon, and I took one strip of turkey bacon, cooked it up nice and crisp, broke it up into like little pieces, and then sprinkled it all over the cheese in between the layers as I was cooking it on the stove. That actually turned out really, really good. It's a little extreme for a toasted cheese, but yeah, it's really good.
It's just about then the boat comes back to shore and a man walks by my window. And I'm like, son, is that you?
He's like, no, father, leave me alone. Very well. I'd like to begin the cross-examination.
Before this trial is done, I'm going to break that man's finger and shove it down his throat. This isn't decisive, this is circumstantial. Let's be fair, karma, it gonna get some karma.
There is nothing to question in my witness's testimonies. Ergo, no need for cross-examination. Besides, there are only 10 seconds left before our 3 minutes are up.
Well, guess what, Von Garma? Your prediction's going to be off
by this much!
Okay. Some pro cooks on YouTube say that you should use mayonnaise on the outside of your grilled cheese. It browns a little nicer, and then butter. Never tried it. I should. I have noticed that, like, if you want to make a really, really good double cheeseburger, you make fry sauce, and you layer that in to the burger. And then you melt the cheese on, you go through the whole process. Oh!
Judge, your verdict now.
Yes. Mr. Wright, cross-examine. What are you saying? Of course I'll cross-examine the witness. Very well, you may begin. Excuse me, Mr. Von Garma?
3 minutes just passed! Don't make me a little bitch! I mean, wrong!
I see. Well then, let's just take our time.
Boom! AKA Cinder Fry Sauce, yes. A little bit of ketchup, a little bit of mayonnaise. If you want to get a little spicy, you can put actually a small amount like mustard, probably Dijon mustard in there. Mix it up. And then, yeah. To be fair, you don't taste the mayonnaise like you think you do, SJ. Yeah.
I see, well. The judge is dropping that mic. You may cross-examine the witness. Okay. Night of the 24th, just after midnight.
in the restaurant where I, then I heard a bang. And where did the bang seem to come from?
Hey! Hey, from the lake, I figure.
You shouldn't. You said it.
Wait, Karma? Why is he putting into question this now? Yep.
Good. Continue.
Oh, okay. Well, I really thought he'd be like, the boat floating on the lake. Then I heard another bang. So you heard two gunshots total.
Yep.
That's what Lotta said in her testimony yesterday. Just then the boat comes back to shore and a man walks by the window. Okay, let's see. Who was the man by your window?
Yep, by my window. Right outside the window of my little shack.
And could you see the man's face?
Well, the fog was pretty darn thick, but he was right there in front of me. I saw him.
This is a rather important detail. Please add to your testimony. I have a bad feeling about this.
That man was the defendant. Yeah, he was saying, I can't believe he's dead.
Hold it. Are you sure? Uh-oh. Dad! I feel like the judge of our comics, she'd be like, Dad!
Hey! Dead shirt, Keith! He said, I can't believe he's dead. He was walking by, too.
Witness! Are you sure that the person you saw was Miles Edgeworth?
It was him! That Edgeworth boy! Hey! Somebody get me up! Like a turtle. I can't roll. Help. Hand down. Dig it down. Keith. Get Papa.
This sounds like decisive evidence indeed.
So I see no room for doubt.
On Karma. He lured me into a cross-examining so he could set me up for a fall.
Nick! I don't like the way things are going here. Everyone in the courtroom is glaring at us.
Better act quick or this trial is gonna go over.
Objection!
Your Honor! So Edgeworth is on trial, yep. We proved in yesterday's trial that it could not have been Edgeworth who fired that gun.
Mr. Wright! Are you referring to the fingerprints from Edgeworth's right hand found on the gun? And the photograph showing a man firing with his left hand?
Exactly.
This is easily explainable. He could have wiped his prints after he fired. You are ignoring the truth of the matter.
I think you're ignoring the fact that he knew he was aware to wipe the prints off the gun, but then touched the gun again to not wipe the prints again? Karma, baby. You're old. You're not senile.
Everything in the witness testimony is true.
The judge is lost in thought. What should I do? Raise an objection. Your Honor, this witness claims that Edgeworth said, I can't believe he's dead. But his words is all we have. If he were telling a lie.
Mr. Wright, in a court of law, the evidence tells all. Apparently, you have yet to realize even this basic fact.
No, the evidence can guide you to a certain situation. Because sometimes it is subjectable.
If you say his testimony is a lie, show us proof. Nick, do we have evidence?
No good. There's nothing I can do. Maya! Maya, come from heaven. Help me. Are you sure? To be honest? I don't know what to do anymore.
Please! Can you hear me, sis? Please! I need your power of the boobs! Let it guide me. We need your help. Nick needs you. 3 minutes was perhaps too high an expectation. However, 15 minutes isn't bad. This must be a new record.
Enough! The witness may leave the stand. Wait, they never picked him up? Grandpa fell and he couldn't get back up. Apparently, they're just gonna step on him. Yep. We never saw him leave, therefore he may still be on the ground. This court sees no reason to further prolong the trial. Nor is there any need for any more to decide the case against the defendant. The case is extremely clear that I see no room for misinterpretation of the facts.
What? No!
This court finds the defendant Mr. Miles Edgeworth. The accused will surrender court immediately? He held pending trial at a higher court with a- wait. Oh god.
Wait!
Me! Who's me? Huh? What? Larry? What are you doing here?
Listen, you gotta listen to me. I was there in the park the night of the murder. I wasn't sure about it until just yesterday. But today I remembered it.
Remembered what?
The gunshot. I heard it too.
Oh, order?
What is the meaning of this? The verdict has been decided. I call for adjournment.
One moment, Mr. Von Karma. So, you say you heard a gunshot.
Yeah, I did. A gunshot, that night. I was sitting here in the audience listening to the testimony. Then I realized something he said was different from what I remember. Anyhow, I can't just sit here and let you all call Edgy a murderer. It's just not right. I'll testify. Let me testify.
Larry Butts. The Harry Butts to the rescue. Order! Order! Well, this is the first time something has happened like this in my court. Not quite sure how to proceed.
Judge! You've already given your decision. The trial is over.
Nick! This is it. Larry's given us a final chance at this.
He's right. If only was it Larry. He could make things even worse.
Mr. Edgeworth was just declared guilty, Nick. It doesn't get any worse.
Right, okay. Yeah, so somehow Mia calls him Harry versus Larry because Harry Butts. Your Honor, if there is another witness, it is our duty to hear him out. Right here, right now.
A waste of time! The verdict cannot be overturned!
Allow me to speak my opinion. In all court proceedings, it is our duty to prevent an inaccurate verdict. In order to make sure no mistake has been made, every witness should be heard.
What is this?
I withdraw my previous verdict of guilty.
Ooh.
Got this right here, comma.
These nuts and gravel, come on.
Mr. Von Karma, how do you call this new witness to testify? Now.
What?
The court will adjourn for a 5-minute recess. After that, we will hear this new witness. Court is adjourned.
Ooh.
Whew. That was too close. Try to keep you on the edge of your seat there like that, Edgeworth.
I've seen worse.
Yeah, right, Edgeworth. You're sweating bullets.
Just wonder what Larry plans to say in there. Larry was at Lake that night, right?
Yes. He said he went looking for the Steel Samurai balloon that flew into the lake.
Oh, right.
And he found the balloon and the air tank that night.
Oh, Eddie found the balloon and the air tank that night.
Yeah?
Hey, Edgeworth.
Huh? You say something, Rat?
Yeah, a lot of things. You seem out of it. What's wrong?
It's nothing.
Mr. Edgeworth, there's something I've been meaning to ask you.
What's that?
Why are your fingerprints on the murder weapon?
Oh. Mess up, Edgeboo.
You know, we never got his account of what happened on the boat.
When he fell into the lake, I went into a daze. I couldn't understand what had happened. I couldn't think straight. And I saw the pistol lying on the floor of the boat in front of me. I picked it up without thinking. I never reasoned, really.
I see.
Right. Yeah? This might be our chance. Our chance. Von Karmer has only ever run perfect trials. Perfectly prepared witnesses, perfectly complete evidence. That's the secret to his success. He stacks the goddamn cards up, is what he does. Eating Lang, son of a bitch. I mean, most lawyers like to do that anyway, but you gotta adapt on the fly, right?
This is the first time he's ever had to deal with something unexpected. He has let someone he hasn't even talked to testify before the court. That someone is Larry.
The Murphy Law of the game. What are you getting at?
It's likely his testimony will be full of holes, right? That's right, Nick! No 10-minute trial this time, and we'll milk this one for all it's worth. It was 15 minutes. 15. Everything's on Larry now.
Dead man walking! Court is now back in session. Witness, please testify to the court about everything that you saw on the night of December 24th.
Right! Leave it to me!
Please, Larry, don't mess this one up. I hate to admit it, but you're our last chance.
Von Karmer didn't even have time to prep his witness. I just hope Edgeworth is right about this being our big break.
The night of the murder.
That night, I was out in a boat on the lake. I was looking for something, or I found it. So I quietly slipped the boat back into the rental shop dock. Then just as I was thinking about going home, I heard this bang! I looked out over the lake, but I didn't see a boat. After I heard that single gunshot, I went home.
He's lying! Again! Larry! For once, do me a favor. Tell the goddamn truth. Just do that for me. You're not even on trial. Just... Okay. Every time he sweats, he's lying.
That was an unusually vague testimony even for this court.
In any case, Mr. Wright, you may begin your cross-examination. Yes, Your Honor.
What's wrong, Nick? It's Larry. I have no idea what he's going to say if I press him. I'm a little scared.
Mia, hold me.
Well, we've come this far. There's no way to go but forward, Nick.
You know what? I'm gonna press him on this for one reason. Well, I don't believe the tank setting off would make a gun sound. It might, even though I'm pretty sure it's just the poppers.
Looking for something.
Yeah. Mr. Butts, what was it you were looking for?
What the witness was searching for is irrelevant. Most likely he was hunting for this Gordy.
That's surprisingly close to the truth, in sense.
This is irrelevant! Let's get it over with!
Back to the dock.
Hold it!
Where did the sound come from? I wasn't too sure about it. I looked around, you know.
Did you look at the lake?
Yeah, I looked. Wasn't there a boat on the lake? Remember, the gun was shot 3 times, right? What if the first shot was on land, second shot on boat, but where was the third? Unless, miraculously, that's the same gun. No.
Order. Well, Mr. Butts.
Everybody just calm down, okay? I mean, it was real foggy that night. I'm not sure whether there was a boat out there or not. Oh, okay, no problem. That's just the most important part of this whole case. You went home. Okay, see how he went from one to the other? That sucked, buddy. You know, one of these days, we're gonna have to play L.A. Noir. That game rides off of, like, tone and facial expressions to interrogate. So you only heard one bang, correct?
Yeah.
Huh. Well, Nick?
It's a pretty wishy-washy testimony, wasn't it? I should just start working on the contradictions.
Sorry. I wish I could be more helpful. I wish I could call my sister.
Okay, so that night I was out on the lake. I was looking for something and I found it, right? But I slipped the back boat into the rental dock.
Around what time was that?
Let's see. I figured I was out searching for about an hour. I guess it was around like 12, yeah?
You're not sure. Hey, don't give me that face. I'm not some sort of human sundial, okay?
People use watches these days, Larry. They also have cell phones, I think.
Okay, let's take a look at the evidence here, chat.
File in the DL6 incidents. Two sounds just after midnight.
Didn't see a boat. So after that single gunshot, I went home.